All right. So we ordered some furniture for the front room here, but I haven't converted this or Smart House did. I just basically take this area here and I leave it just closed off. I don't do anything. The only smart feature we have here is the Alexa over there. Cancel. For the whole house audio. These lights are not smart lights yet. They will be later on. But there's some stuff I have to do the floor. I'm going to have to restain some of this. And that's a weather stripping for the door there. So we're going to get on this here. I ordered a chemical, and it's called Rejuvenate something. I'll put a link below when I actually do this video. It'll probably be a week before I do the video, so for you, it'll just be a moment, but we're going to repair this floor, and today I got some furniture coming. I'll probably have to assemble it. I'm not sure how that works yet, but this room is just for meeting people. For when guests come, like my parents or whoever comes out, family, whatever. So, I gotta work on this. I've gotta redo there. I'm probably have to get a TV up there or something. Or maybe a projector. I don't know. I got the other projector. We'll see. But like I said, this room isn't really worked on yet. Because, you know, we don't use it. But I gotta pull all the stuff off the wall. I found blowgun darts in the wall. We'll figure on that one, huh? But I need to finish this, but I want to give you a view of the place before I did anything on it. And specifically, I want you to see the floors, how bad they are. So, I mean, just this one spot where they just did. Now, this just is going to be covered up with, you know, refinishing, but these are the spots that are bad. I don't know what happened there, but that actually looks damaged. I probably have to actually sand that down and repair it the best we can. Well, we might even just repair it by putting a carpet over it. But I don't know where I'm putting that couch yet. So we ordered those. They came through Amazon. Every place wanted $1,500 for what I liked. And I found these on Amazon for about five or six for two of them. So you gotta have some furniture out here. Like I said, it's not really high quality. But we will probably never use this except for when someone's here, guest or whatever. I mean, like I said, I'll put a big TV up here, but I don't know. I really don't like the color, but too bad what I like. I'm not ready to work on it and paint. But anyway, this will all be a smart house, smart fans up there. The dining room light, I guess that's the dining room, living room, dining room. And the other one's a den area, I guess, on the other side. I'm not sure. I have to look at the floor plans the guy drew up for us. All right. So when I get ready to do this, I'll edit this video all together and put these in. We'll see. All right. Have a good one. All right. So I've got my furniture in. This is how it comes. I have my ramps for my lawnmower into my truck to get up these stairs here. So, that's how they gave it to me. So, yeah. So let's see if how it comes. It looks like it's obviously disassembled. I'm gonna have to assemble the couches. They don't look damaged in any way to me. But you know, who can tell? But, all right, let's get inside. I'll have to break this apart, use my dolly and get it inside. I have too many dang steps here. So, figure it out. All right, I'll get this inside and we'll continue on. So it's finally in. I should get some weeds with it. But here it is. Let me get it open and I'll show you what it looks like inside there. So it's open now and this is how it comes. It has a protection strip for the knives. I was very careful anyway, but just saying. So that's how it comes. That's a small one. This is a big one. It's going to require assembly, I'm sure. So, there's plenty of videos on assembly out there, so I'll just probably skip that part and just go ahead and do it. It should be pretty simple. Actually, there's assembly instructions. There. We don't need a video. Everything's inside, put it together, screw it together. tighten it. So I'll be back once it's all done. And then I don't know where to set the stuff. I'll have to have the wife do that, tell me where to put it. But that's the assembly instructions. Very, very simple. So I'll be back once all done. All right, so I went ahead and unpacked it. A lot of the stuff, like the cushions and such, were actually inside the couch, the base. So yeah. It looks like that'd be a good storage area for something. It's just held on by Velcro, though, the base cover, so you could easily lift up the couch and pull whatever out of there, get storage. I bet a number 10 can fit in there. Hey, if you don't have room, you do what you gotta do, but... And this looks like a... It looks like pine down there. But it'd be pretty easy to reinforce this if you were gonna, you know, seriously use it. Kind of got like a... The strap's like a lawn chair design. Without the cushions, it'd probably be pretty uncomfortable, but... If you were to run some really quality boards through there, I bet this thing would really hold up well. Alright, let me go ahead and get it undone though. The instructions actually had more to them. Hold on, let me find them. Alright, here they are. See, what we saw was the front, but there's the inside of the instructions, and it's very... Come on, focus. It's very easy to put together. So, all the kit came with the whole kit. There's the parts. It came with a big strap, I guess, so it didn't fall out or get lost, I don't know. Alright, so let me get this thing put together, and then we'll see how it is. I'll be back. So as you can see, this is just stapled in. If there's a problem, and I doubt there will be, but if there's a problem, I would take and I'll just put drywall screws on, glue it. But like I said, I might rebuild this. This Velcro's across. I might rebuild all this. It's like particle board. Thin particle board there, but you know, if you wanted to reinforce it, you easily could. Like I said, this is like lawn chair strapping. Where is it? There we go. Anyway, let me finish in the thing. I've been on about maybe 4 or 5 minutes already, so let me get to it. So what do you think about it?
I love it.
So there it is. Alright, go ahead and get off so I don't put your face on the camera. Go ahead and move.
Do what?
Move, get off the couch. Okay, so there it is. There's the couch and love seat, just like it, only it's two sections. So it's pretty firm, which I thought would be kind of flimsy, but it's not. And like I said, if there's ever a problem, I can reinforce it, but I think it'd be really good underneath for food storage or, you know, storage. But if you live in a small apartment or something, you don't have room. I mean, when I first started out, I made furniture out of number 10 cans. I'd stack it up and then I'd put a bed sheet or a cloth over it and use it like a little lamp table or something. But that was all number 10 cans. So I like it. What do you think about it? What's your recommendation? Think it's a good deal?
A very good deal.
I think we paid about $555 maybe for this, or
yeah, something.
It was $550 or $600 or something for two of them. I haven't got the other one up yet, but I'll put a link below, and I'm pretty pleased. It's sturdy. It feels like leather. I don't know. Dog hasn't punched holes in it yet. I'm sure that's probably coming, but like I said, we're hardly going to use this room anyway, just for guests once we get it decorated and stuff, but. That's pretty much it. I'm going to go ahead and give it a thumbs up and recommend it if you guys need cheap furniture. I don't think you could run and jump on it, but, well, I guess you could, but it'd probably break if you did. But I think this is pretty nice. it's about what you get at the cheap furniture stores for about $900,000 maybe.
Yeah, probably about $900,000.
$900,000. So if you're willing to spend, I think it's like 20 minutes putting together. There's two bolts on the arms, each arm, and four on the back and the legs. And then the whole bottom Velcros across, so you could open it and get in there really easy from underneath if you flipped it over. So it's good hidden storage. I mean, security through obscurity isn't, as they say, but I don't know. I might put something in there that I might need one day. All right. Have a good one, everybody. Cincy P out.